So we denote the matrices by capital letters, capital A, capital B, capital C, X, etc. With the help of elements also we can represent matrices. So let's see that also. Order of a matrix. We'll discuss this part also. Order of a matrix. Let us consider a matrix A equal A11, A12, A13, dot dot dot, A1n. These are the entries in this matrix A in the first row, and it has n columns. Then let us make entries in the second row. So A21, A22, A23, and so on, A2n. Likewise, keep on making entries. The last one let us take AM1. AM2, AM3, until the last one is AMN. So we find here that there are m rows and n columns. So in this matrix, there are m rows and n columns. So what is the order of this matrix? If it has m rows and n columns, then this matrix A is of order m by n. This is read as m by n. So this is the order of the matrix. So this m by n we can write here also. So this is an m by n matrix. So m by n matrix A. Now let us see here, if I write any element Aij for this matrix, and if I give m by n, and if we take the values of I from 1 to m and the values of j from 1 to n, where I comma j both belongs to capital N. Capital N stands for natural numbers. So this A, matrix A, can be represented with the help of this element Aij in this form also. So what is Aij? Aij is an element of this matrix in ith row and jth column. It is also known as ijth element. So Aij is an element in ith row and jth column. So it is ijth element of matrix A. So A can be in symbolically A can be written as Aij m by n. So it's a m by n matrix, so it has an order m by n. So for order, let us take some examples so that this will be more clear to you. See one example. Suppose if I am writing 1, 2, 3, minus 1, 0, 5. So there are two rows. So first we enter for rows, we write 2. And three columns, so we write 2 by 3. If I take a matrix B with 2, 4, 6, 8. So there are two rows and two columns. So what is the order of this matrix? 2 by 2. So in this way we write the order of matrices. So similarly, if I take one more example, suppose 1, 2, 3, 4, 7, 9. So here in this matrix you see there is only one column and there are 6 rows. So we can write 6 by 1. Okay. So we discuss some basic examples related to this order and elements of matrix. So we have seen matrices as rectangular arrangement of numbers which has no value, it has got no numerical value. We can take elements as numbers, functions, scalar, vector quantities, and it has wide application in various fields. So after this, let us do some basic simple applications examples. simple examples. Like first one, if I write a matrix A, in matrix A, the entries are 1, 2, 3, minus 1, 7, 9, 10, 11, 13, 15, minus 19, 0. Then, first of all, what is the order of this matrix? What is the order of matrix A? First question. Second, what are the elements? What are the elements? A 2 3 comma A 1 1 comma A 3 2 etc. Then third one, how many elements are there? How many elements or entries are there in matrix A? So three questions, basic questions. So first one, what is the order of the matrix? So let's see how many horizontal lines and how many vertical lines are there. Horizontal lines are our rows and vertical lines are our columns. So what is the order of this matrix? So order is, there are three rows. Order of matrix A is three rows, so we write three, and there are four columns, so we write four. So the order of this matrix is 3 by 4. Second, A23 is an element in the second row and third column. So let's go to the second row and third column. Second row is this one, third column is this one. So if I make these dotted lines, so these dotted lines meet at each other at the element 9. So A23 is 9. Similarly, for A11, first row, first column, the element is 1. This is the element in the first row, first column, so it's 1. Then A32, third row, second column. This is the third row, second column. So these two lines meet each other at 15, so we write 15 here. So these are the elements A23, A11, A32. These numbers in the suffixes 2, 3, 1, 1, 3, 2, these represents rows and columns, and it gives the position of the element in the matrix. How many elements are there in the matrix A? So let's multiply the number of rows and columns. So total number of elements is equals to 3 rows, 4 columns, so total 12 elements are there. So with this we have a simple idea of elements, their position and the order of the matrix. Now let us see a second example, in which we construct a matrix with the help of given Aij. So construct a matrix or write a matrix of order. Write a matrix, question number 2, matrix of order. Let's take simple 2 by 2, where matrix A of order 2 by 2, where A equal Aij is the matrix of order 2 by 2, in which Aij is given by I plus j upon 2. Simply, let us construct a matrix of order 2 by 2. So if it is a matrix of order 2 by 2, so first of all, the matrix A is, there are 2 rows and 2 columns only. So the required elements are A11, A12, A21, A22. 2 by 2 order. Now let's find out A11. What is A11? Aij is defined as I plus j by 2. So I and j both are replaced by 1 each. So we have 2 by 2, it's 1. The next one is A12. So we replace I by 1, it's j by 2, so it's 3 by 2. Then we write A21, so it's 2 plus 1 by 2, so again it is 3 by 2. And A22, so it's 2 plus 2 by 2, so it is 2. So we have the matrix A as, so let's write all these for A11, which is 1, A12 is 3 by 2, A21 is also 3 by 2 and A22 is 2. It's a matrix of order 2 by 2, matrix A. Now one more example. Suppose, let's do one more example related to the possible number of orders of a matrix. So let's construct or just tell the number of question number 3. How many matrices with 15 elements are possible? So let's see, there are 15 elements. So what are the possible factors of 15, prime factors? So with that, with the help of that, we can write the number of possible matrices. So number of possible matrices. First, we can have a matrix of order 1 by 15. So orders can be the possible orders. Possible orders. 1 by 15, 15 by 1, 3 by 5, 5 by 3. Is any other order is possible? You may think of that also. So if we consider this, so then we have total number of possible matrices only 4. So we can write 4 matrices with 15 elements in them. Now the question also comes, if we have a prime number of elements, then how many matrices are possible? Number 4, if a matrix has 11 elements, then how many matrices are possible? So only 2 are possible, because 11 itself is a prime number. So 2 matrices. So 2 matrices with orders 11 by 1 and 1 by 11 are possible. So these are some basic things related to matrices, their representation. So further, we discuss the types of matrices in the next part.